You may or may not know this, but Desmos Graphing Calculator can create music using its tone feature. I certainly knew this, and in a bit you'll be able to create your very own melody as well with this complete, in-depth tutorial with a bit too many details, but that's okay. To make this, we need to use the tone function in Desmos. In Desmos, you can write tone of any number, and Desmos will make a ringtone-like sound, but you may notice not every note will sound in tune. To get notes, we need to use this following equation. The way we can understand this is that our bass note, an A4, is at 440 Hz. Every octave doubles the previous Hz. So an A5 will be 880 Hz, and an A3 will be at 220 Hz. We get the 12 in this equation because there are 12 notes in an octave. The equation is essentially an exponential doubling graph with some transformations. With this knowledge, we can write the notes for certain notes we will use. One exception is if we want to rest in our melody. You can see that I've denoted the value for rest as r equals negative 100. However, I could have really set it at any value less than or equal to 0, because it's below our formula for a note and Desmos wouldn't play any sound for it. Next, we will create a list called measure containing all of our notes, with each value separated by commas. I may randomly assign one note to be the length for an eighth note, and as a result, four of these elements would make a half note. By this, I mean one element in the list is an eighth note. Or I could randomly assign one note to be a 16th note if I have a faster paced song. In this case, four notes would make a quarter note. This is because in a list, when multiple copies of a note are in sequence, Desmos concatenates them to make a larger version of the same note. One problem that may arise is if I have two quarter notes in sequence that are the same. For example, in this tune, I have four quarter notes that are all the same, but this is what Desmos plays. The way I accomplish what I want is by making my list larger. This essentially increases the potential complexity. In fact, I may double or quadruple the size. What I mean is that if one element in a list is a quarter note, if I make one element be worth an eighth note, but double the speed of the whole song, I accomplish pretty much the same thing with more complexity. Now, two elements are worth a quarter note, compared with before two elements would have been a whole note. You can see that I've doubled the potential complexity. Plus, I can now add rest after each note is played on the downbeat. Listen to what it sounds like now. Better, right? However, if that sounds too spaced out, by making each note worth a 16th note, four elements now make up a quarter note, and I can have three of the notes and then a rest like so. Listen to how it sounds now. It's not a perfect solution, but it sounds good. The next step is to make a melody as long as I want, and we need to use some math for this. Let's say each element in a list is the 16th note, each list has three measures, and the measures are all in 4-4 time. Because I'm in 4-4 time and each list has three measures, that means there will be 12 quarter notes in a list. But, because each element is a 16th note, and there are 4 16th notes in a quarter note, each list will have 12 times 4 equals 48 elements. Next, I can make elements either in series or parallel. This to me is the coolest part about tone in Desmos, because I can do what I couldn't have before. I can make harmonies. You can see the method I've used here. I have M sub 101, 102, and 103, which are three separate harmonies in my first group of measures, aka 3, and then I have M sub 201 and 202 for my next two measures and my next group of three measures. Now is the time where you need to translate sheet music into notes in a list in Desmos. This could probably be done with a computer program, but I love hard coding, so that's what I did. This requires some knowledge about reading music, but I'll start you off with the basics. Middle C, or the C between a treble and bass clef, is a C5, and the octave switches every C. So the one above is a C6, and the one below is a C4. Another bit of info, feel free to transpose for non-concert pitch instruments, but I've always searched up piano sheet music, because piano sheet music always has harmonies and is already a concert pitch. You can also feel free to find other arrangements with instruments like strings, because they are also in concert pitch. Now the final step, putting it all together. After you finish making all of your measure lists, you need to connect them up to a ticker. With the ticker tool, I can determine the exact time I want for whatever beats per minute I want. Using some stoichiometry, I know that a 90 BPM song converts into incrementing T every 112 milliseconds by getting notes in the numerator and milliseconds in the denominator. Here is my result. Now, a quick note from our sponsor. Me. Yeah, I created that, and yeah, that was a clip from a recent video I made. So, if you're enjoying this and find it informative, please subscribe to the channel. It helps the algorithm by recommending this video to other people like you who may also want to watch this. Thanks, and back to the video. One thing you'll see is the aesthetics I've put on my graph, with the moving line and the colors. I've decided not to go into detail about all of that stuff because it is not related to creating music per se, but I'm linking this Desmos tutorial graph in the description for you to peruse. Now that you know how to create, I heavily recommend trying this for yourself to create music in Desmos. If you do make any melody, any song, any video game song, any TV intro, please let me know by commenting below. I look forward to seeing what you make and have a great rest of your day.